Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMi RPG sample video. I'm wondering if you ever need to use regular expressions in RPG. Regular expressions are something that is used in many other languages, for example, JavaScript, Python, and can be very useful. I show you an example of how they can be used in our RPG programs. Let's go. For anyone who doesn't know, a regular expression is nothing more than a sequence of characters that form a search pattern. This pattern is used to check character sequences. With regular expressions, we can, for example, check if a sequence of characters corresponds to a valid email address, an URL, a valid password, etc. It is a bit complex to explain, but there are many places where regular expressions are discussed. If we are used to using ChatGPT, we can also ask it for a regular expression. We are already in VS Code, and we are going to make a small program in RPG. In RPG, we can check if a string of characters complies with a regular expression using embedded SQL. As I said before, the program must be SQL RPG since we are going to use SQL functions. Okay, so let's create a new program here. Test. Okay. Well, our program will check if a string of characters, a word, starts with a capital A, is 5 characters long, and ends with the lowercase letter N. Actually, doing this check is simple without having to use regular expressions. But imagine how complex our regular expressions can be. Well, to do this, let's write our regular expression. In this case, it will be this. Well, this means that the first character must be an A. After that, we are going to have 3 characters that can be a letter between A and Z. And finally, there must be a letter N. Well, let me write the program. As always, we're going to make a program without the cycle. Okay, let's create the main procedure. And in this case, I'm going to use a different procedure to check if the text that I'm using as a parameter is valid or not. Okay, so if check test text A B C D N is equal to not valid, then I will send a message to the job log as this, not valid. If not, I will say valid. Okay. Let me copy this and try again with a different string. Okay. Now let me declare the subprocedure that is going to be check text. And we are going to have an entry like this with one character that I'm going to return and an input parameter like this, more character const, okay, something like this, okay? And let me declare the regular expression that we are going to use, that is going to be, as I said before, this one, A. After that, a 3 and an N. Okay. We're going to declare the character that I'm going to return the result of the execution of the procedure. By default, it is false, okay? And let me do this. Set equal to text. Let's see. Okay. So this SQL function is doing all the work. It will return true if the text complies with the regular expression or false if not. You can search the IBMI documentation to read more about this function and others related to regular expressions. Okay, let me compile this. Okay, oh, I have something wrong. Let me see. Oh, sorry. Let me declare this as not valid. It's going to be this. Okay. Let me try again. Okay. This okay. And okay, let me run it into the green screen and see how it works. Okay, let me start the debug session. Test 86. Okay, let me stop it here and call the program. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is to call to this sub-procedure with this parameter, okay? So let's go in and let me do this. And what I'm getting is this one. False. Okay, that means that the text variable text does not match with the regular expression. Okay, so I'm returning a false. So I'm sending this message to the job log, not valid. Okay, let me try again with this different string. And in this case, what I'm getting is a true. Okay, so this is valid. And I'm sending this message to the job log. Okay. If I see my job log, this is the first call to the function, and this is the second call. Okay. Okay, as you can see, this is a very good option to check that a string of characters meets certain requirements using regular expressions. The good thing is that we don't have to change the code if we change the regular expression. There is no need to loop search for substrings or count characters. This function does everything in a very simple way. I encourage you to try it with other regular expressions and with other strings. You will see that this works very well. I hope you like this video. Press the like button in that case, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And as always, thanks for watching.